Thule cargo box that I have, and I used the power of the YouTubes to look up how to fix it, and found a pretty good video by another fella, and I just thought I would make another one that was a little bit more in detail. So the first thing you do is identify where the cracks are, and then you're going to want to clean all of the dirt and grime off of it with some kind of a cleaner. I just used white gas, otherwise known as Coleman fuel. Just rub some of that around on there. And then I got a couple of other products that I'm going to apply over this to fix the crack. And I'll show you those.
So here are basically the tools I'm going to be using. In the back there, I've got my little camping canister of white gas that I use for my camping stove. You can probably get some other industrial cleaner if you need. And then I went to Home Depot and I got a 6x6, sort of a fiberglass. It's called a wall repair patch, so basically a fiberglass mesh tape. And that has an adhesive on the back, so it'll stick to the surface pretty well. But then in order to really, solidify and truly fix the box, you need to put some kind of an epoxy or whatever you want to call it over it. And I picked up this PL Premium. It's just by Loctite. All of these materials here, like both the Loctite and the wall repair patch kit, I believe I maybe spent about $8 on it. So here's the second crack. I showed you the one in the video a minute ago earlier of the first crack. This second one here, I've taken and cut a piece of the reinforcing mesh tape and stuck it on the box there. I, of course, had already cleaned it with the white gas, and then the next step will be to apply some of the PL Premium epoxy. Once you've got some of the compound laid on there, it recommends that you wear some kind of gloves or finger protection before touching the stuff, since it's toxic. So I'm just using a little plastic bag here. Now, I didn't put tons of it on here, so I may have to come through with a second batch. We'll see. Kind of ugly. So if you're looking for a really clean project that ends up having, sort of a show quality finish, you probably have to use some sanding equipment and paint. But since this is just, for me, this is just needs to work. It doesn't need to look great. I'll probably be happy with just how it is there. The other crack I've been looking at. So I'm just going to kind of lay out the fiberglass tape, get a measurement on it, and then I will go at it with the scissors. Now, it has a little bit of a plastic coating on it. You'll want to make sure that you pull that off. So now, in the application that I'm using this for here, you can see that I'm trying to keep this slider track and this device here free from any interruption. So I will be real careful to put this stuff down in such a way that it doesn't hit that. The process of putting on the adhesive and spreading it around. So there we have it, a couple of halfway decent repair jobs. I mean, not pretty, but just got to do the job, right?